Yes, these are students. So the previous class we have discussed in detail about the consumer exploitation. Now, what do we call consumerism? Consumerism, need for consumerism, and importance of consumerism is the topic today we are going to see. First of all, the term consumerism is came to in the early 1960s, came into practice early 1960s. It is a social force. Consumerism is a social force which is designed to protect the consumers. It's a social force designed to protect the consumers from unfair marketing practices. Then the producers, the sellers and the service providers give importance to consumers. Producer, whether they may be producer or the seller or the service provider, they have to give more importance to the consumer, because every one of us are consumers. The consumers may be individuals, families and even organization, and they are providing they are using or consuming the products and enjoying various services like hospitals, education institutions, transport and banking services. So not only consuming of products and also consuming of various types of services. So every one of us are consumers. The consumers may be individuals, families and even organization. The consumerism, the word first coined by businessman in the year 1960s, and he thought that consumer movement is another ISM. Consumer movement is another ISM, like socialism, communism and capitalism. So the consumerism is the word coined by the businessman in the mid-1960s. He thought that consumer movement is another ISM in the row of socialism, communism and capitalism. Then definitions of consumerism. There are three definitions for consumerism. First one, the definition given by L. Massey. According to him, consumerism is an attempt to increase the rights and powers of consumers, enhance the rights and powers of consumers in relation to the seller or buying and selling of commodities. So according to L. Massey, consumerism is an attempt which enhance or increase the rights and powers of consumer in connection with or related to seller. That means buying and selling of commodities. Then another definition by William Standen for consumerism. So according to him, consumerism is the actions of individual, organization and in response to the consumer dissatisfaction. So it is an actions of the individuals, kind of institutions or organization in response to consumer dissatisfaction regarding or which is arising out of exchange of goods and services. The consumers are dissatisfied while exchanging of goods and services. So it's a combined action of the individuals as well as the organization which are related to the dissatisfaction which is arising out of the exchange of goods and services. So this is the definition given by William Standen for consumerism. And third definition, Cliff Coulter is another definition given. According to him, consumerism is not limited to organized effort. So consumerism is not limited to organized efforts and also a social movement, which augment the rights and powers of consumers, increase or augment the rights and powers of consumers in relation to the seller. So it is an obvious effort and also social movement which is highly needed for the rights and powers of consumer related to buying and selling of commodities. So these are the three definitions. This is two mark question. Define consumerism means you have to write any two definitions about the consumerism. So according to L. Massey, consumerism is an attempt, he explained about it, it is an attempt to increasing the rights and powers of consumer. Whereas William Standen explains, it is the actions of the individual as well as organization which are related to the consumer dissatisfaction while exchanging of consumer exchange of goods and services. And according to Tim Kotler, it is an honest effort. Consumerism is an honest effort and also a social movement. Consumerism is a social movement which augments the rights and powers of consumers in relation to seller. So there are three definitions. So this is the meaning of consumerism or introduction about the consumerism. This is definition of consumerism. Apart from that, the consumerism is a protest. Consumerism is a protest against the unfair marketing practices or injustices, against the injustices for purchasing of goods and services. So consumerism is a protest which is against the unfair method of practices or unscrupulous way of trading as well as injustices. And the aim of the consumerism is reducing, removing, uprooting and elimination of the unfair method of practices or marketing practices and injustices. So the important aim of consumerism is reducing, removing, uprooting and eliminating of unfair method of marketing practices. So the unfair method of practices, so in the previous class I explained in detail about the way in which the consumers are exploited. So I repeat the same points. Unsafe product, supply of unsafe product, adulteration, defective packaging, false and misleading advertisement, hoarding, profiteering, black marketing, misuse of brands, planned obsolescence, short or undertaken measures, the unwanted goods rather than the goods offered by the consumer, supply of unwanted goods rather than the goods which are offered by the consumer, the supply of duplicated products, selling of product at higher prices, and denying of warranty and services. So you bear in all the points. Whatever the question asked in the consumerism chapter, you may restore and explain all the points, very easy one. So you should remember all the unfair method of practices. Not only the subject related, and also a consumer, as well as a commerce students. So you should bear in mind all the unfair method of practices and also fight against this unfair trade practices and also injustices. Then the next topic is significance or importance of consumerism. So there are 7 points. So you know, I will just list out that. Awakening and uniting the consumers against the unfair trade practices. So create awareness among the consumers and also united the consumers to fight against the unfair trade practices, awakening and uniting of consumers. And awakening the government, so by way of conducting various protests and other practices, so we should create the government by way of awakening method of practices, awakening the government. Discouraging the unfair method of marketing practices. So under no circumstances we should allow the unfair method of practices. We should not allow the unfair method of practices. Then discouraging of anti-social elements or activities. So this highly affect the health also, not only the wastage of money and also affect the human health also. So discouraging the anti-social activities. No way to honor the anti-social activities in our society. Then protecting the consumer against the exploitation. So that is very important. So the consumerism is highly useful for the consumers to fight against the consumer exploitations. Then provide complete and the latest information about the product. Only in the presence of the consumerism, the consumer can get the information which is a complete one and also a latest one. So giving up or providing complete and the latest information to the consumers only by the presence of, only in the presence of consumerism. Then effective implementation of consumer laws. So a number of laws are being implemented by the government to protect the consumer against the social practices. So that should be properly implemented only with the help of the consumerism. So only in the presence of consumerism only we have to achieve all these things. So in such a way the consumerism are gets important, that is the significance of the consumerism. So with this end of the introduction about the consumerism, definition about the consumerism, need for consumerism, as well as the importance of consumerism. So the next week we'll see about the origin, evolution and the growth of consumerism. We will see in the next class.